let's talk about what might be the elephant in the room this week for some of you, climate change. You may think it's a political hot-button issue, but I'm here to tell you that it's not a political issue. It doesn't need to be a political issue. We're just talking about the science of our Earth that we live on and our ancestors have lived on for years and years and years. And our Earth is pretty amazing. There's no other planet in our solar system that can support our life. And the reason why our Earth is able to support water, plant life, you and I, is because of our atmosphere. It's pretty amazing. This is kind of a slice into our atmosphere. And this atmosphere is like a blanket. And it protects us. It protects us from the heat of the sun. It protects us from what's happening in outer space. And it, like Goldilocks and the Three Bears, the atmosphere has to be just right to support life on Earth. That's why other planets don't have life, because Mars and Venus, their atmospheres are either too big or too small. But our atmosphere is just perfect. But our atmosphere has been changing, and our Earth has been changing over many, many, many years. Our climate has been changing as the Earth goes through, of course, natural processes of heating and cooling. But some of these changes in the last 100 years, we've got to talk about. Now our atmosphere is made up of gases, right? You know about oxygen and nitrogen. Those are the largest components of what our air is outside. But we also have about 1% of these gases that are called greenhouse gases. Water vapor is one of them. Carbon dioxide is one of them as well. And carbon dioxide is something we got to talk about, because these greenhouse gases behave a little bit differently. Okay? Normally we have energy from the sun that's coming into the Earth, and some of that energy is able to be readmitted through our atmosphere back into outer space. That's why our Earth doesn't get way too hot. But some of these greenhouse gases help to trap that heat from the sun. It kind of locks it into place. Well, as we keep pumping more and more of one particular greenhouse gas, carbon dioxide, into the atmosphere, our globe and our atmosphere is slowly warming. And here's the relationship between carbon dioxide and what's happening with our global temperatures. Now you can see both lines since the Industrial Revolution going up at a much faster pace than what was happening back before the Industrial Revolution. Now this may not seem like much because we're zooming in really tight and this is only about 1 degree Celsius. But when you're talking about this on the grand scheme of things, that's a big deal. Where are most of these extra greenhouse gases coming from? Transportation, electricity consumption, right? And industry. That's where most of these greenhouse gases are coming from. But even though our atmosphere may only be heating up by 1 degree Celsius over that 100+ years, most of the heat that is in excess because of those added greenhouse gases is not being stored in our atmosphere. It's being stored in our oceans. In fact, 93% of this extra heat is going directly into our oceans, and our oceans impact the weather. So what does this all mean? Well, it means basically as our oceans warm and our atmosphere warms over many, many years, we're going to see some changes to our weather patterns. What can happen? A warmer atmosphere leads to more extremes with our weather. It can lead to stronger hurricanes. It can lead to more extreme droughts, which can lead to bad wildfire seasons for us. More heavy rain events. As the atmosphere warms, it can hold more water vapor, and that can lead to heavier rains and more flash flooding events. And also, as our atmosphere warms, we're also looking at eventually a rise in sea level. And that can mean some huge changes along our poles. So this week, during Earth Week and Green Week, I want you to think about this not as a political issue, but just as a science issue. This is our home. Earth is our home. And what can you do to reduce your carbon footprint? Whether that be trading in for maybe an electric or hybrid vehicle, turning the lights off in your house more often, maybe eating less meat and more plants. Just think about it. It doesn't have to be political. It's just science.